morning children, we shall continue with lesson 12, cleanliness and hygiene. Today the first topic we are going to discuss is cleanliness of clothes. So first of all, we should wear neat and tidy clothes. You all know this. When we work or when you work, you can say play or exercise, we sweat a lot. Okay, so what happens? The clothes being close to our body, they absorb the sweat from your body. Okay, throughout the day our clothes absorb dirt and dust. If you go out, okay, you go out to school, you go to the market, you go to tuitions, you go. Okay, what happens? The dust, they absorb the clothes, your clothes absorb the dust and the dirt. Okay, so after all day long, clothes start smelling bad and may become favorable for germs to grow. So our clothes, to clean our clothes, it becomes very important to keep us healthy. So we should always wear neat and tidy clothes. So how can you do that? Always wear washed and clean clothes. Clothes should be washed with good quality soap or detergent and water, so that you can use it for quite a long time. Do not keep dirty clothes in cupboards. When you like, you come from outside and you are keeping those clothes in the cupboard, you should not do. Okay, first you should wash them, then you put it in the cupboard or in the almira. Then you should clean your cupboards regularly where you keep your clothes. And when you wash clothes, you should always dry them in the under the sun, actually in the sun. Our other clothes like bed sheets, curtains, sofa covers or carpet should also be cleaned regularly. These are all parts of clothes, whether it is curtain or pillow cover or bed sheet, okay? They also need care. Okay, now we will discuss about cleanliness of food and water, which is very important. Food. Now, we eat food and drink water to keep our body healthy and energetic. Food gives us energy. So what type of food you should eat and where it should be cooked. Okay, if we do not take hygienic food and clean water, the most important thing, hygienic food, it should be where it is prepared, in which place it is prepared. The place should be neat and tidy. The water which you are drinking should be clean. Then only you will be healthy, otherwise you may fall sick. So you can follow some good habits, like for food, wash hands before and after eating. This you all do. Always keep the food covered so that flies and insects do not sit on them. Okay, then do not eat fruits which have been, food should be covered. Our food, always food should be covered so that flies and insects do not sit on it. Okay, and do not eat fruits which have been cut for a long time. If your mummy or someone has cut fruit for a long time, you should not eat that. Okay, because they attract germs. When you eat fruits, you should cut immediately and eat them. And we should always wash fruits and vegetables before eating. Food should be prepared in hygienic places and clean places, where the kitchen should be clean. Okay, and the utensils also should be clean. Now let us come to water. Water plays a very important role. So drinking water should be boiled or filtered. Now store drinking water where we should store the water, in clean vessels or in covered vessels, you can say. We should not put our hands in the drinking water. And we should regularly clean the bottle or the jug from which we are consuming water, because nowadays usually we drink water from the bottles. So we should clean the bottles before filling the water in that. And we should not drink water which is stored for a long time. Like today, if I am storing the water, after 2 days I am going to drink that. No, you should store the water the same day and you should drink it also on the same day. Let us come to cleanliness of our surroundings now, which is very important. If you are neat and clean and your surroundings are dirty, you cannot be healthy. So you have to keep both yourself and your surroundings clean. Okay, our house, you see, our house as well as the places outside the house should be kept clean, both. So things in a house should be dusted and cleaned regularly. Whatever things you have in your house on a regular basis, they should be cleaned. Then floor of the house should be cleaned, okay, and mopped every day. Then flies and mosquitoes, they usually enter our house. So how can we avoid them? You have to find ways, okay, by putting wire mesh on the doors and windows. Then any waste materials or any waste things which you are not using should be thrown in the dustbin, covered dustbins. Okay, otherwise flies or mosquitoes, germs may grow on them. And the dustbins should be cleaned also regularly. Okay, then we should not collect, let water collect in places around our house, because mosquitoes may grow on them and we may fall sick. Then keep the places outside the house also litter free. Any things you should not drop outside the house, you should not make them dirty. Then do not throw wastes on the roads, parks, water bodies and other public places. Your house, anything, you are taking the dustbin and you are throwing it in the any on the roads. You should not do that. Okay? Do not spit in public places. You should not do that. Do not spit. Always spit in the wash basins. Okay. Then throw the wastes in the dustbins, as I said you. Drains in our house or outside our house also should be covered. They should be cleaned regularly so that they do not choke. Means if you are throwing so many things, it will not pass through the drain and it will be choked. Okay, then choke drains may cause dirty water to overflow on the road. What happens usually in the monsoons, you see the road is flooded because the drains are not cleaned. So we should take care of that also. Now they attract bacteria, flies and mosquitoes, and neighborhood garbage bins also need to be cleared regularly. We have to see if you are staying in a neighborhood. So altogether, it becomes our responsibility to see our surroundings are clean. The most important thing, that along with the house, our surroundings should also be clean. Then only we can keep fit and healthy. Okay. Please revise whatever I taught. Cleanliness of clothes, cleanliness of food and water, and cleanliness of our surroundings. Thank you.